Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Scholarships and Funding webinar that we're having today, August 2nd, 2023. The idea with this webinar is that you're going to have all the information required to understand how you can finance your graduate studies. To explain all this information, Rita will be with us. She is the Manager of Graduate Operations in the Engineering Graduate Studies Office. And I am Maria Sandoval, Marketing and Recruitment Specialist in the Engineering Graduate Studies Office. Rita is a super expert explaining all those details about funding. So we hope that this session is very useful for you.
We'll start off by just indicating that there is a website here where you can go to with all the information about graduate studies in the Faculty of Engineering. We've got information about programs, future students, current students, international research and supervisors, funding, scholarships, and awards. And that's what we're going to be focusing on this morning. But our website has got a lot of information that is pertinent to students, and we really encourage you to look at this information if you are interested in pursuing research at the University of Waterloo. The Faculty of Engineering has six departments: chemical engineering, civil and environmental engineering, electrical and computer engineering, mechanical and mechatronics engineering, management sciences, and systems design engineering, as well as two schools, Conrad School of Entrepreneurship and Business and our School of Architecture. Waterloo is unique in that 100% of the ideas developed at Waterloo are owned by the creators. Your ideas are your intellectual property. The first thing you need to do is to define your program. We have course-based and we have research-based. Course-based means you either get a Master of Engineering, Master of Management Science, Business, Entrepreneurship and Technology, which is MBET, or graduate diplomas. These can vary between 8 to 9 courses. It helps to develop your leadership and project management skills. You're interested in developing or in specializing an area of engineering, so you're not focused on research at all. And this will generally take you 1 to 1.5 years to complete, and it's self-funded. And there are co-op opportunities available. To apply to the co-op programs, there are separate applications available. For the research-based, you can either apply to the Master's of Applied Science, which is a master's program, or the PhD, Doctor of Philosophy. So for the MASC, it's 4 to 5 courses, plus an original thesis, research and thesis. You want to develop and join a research group with a supervisor. You may be interested in pursuing further research with a PhD or a career in engineering research. This could take up to 2 years to complete, and it is funded by a supervisor, and there are collaborative programs available. For the Doctor of Philosophy, or PhD, there are 3 to 4 courses, and it is research-based along with a comprehensive exam. You want to develop and join a research group with a supervisor. You may want to do a PhD because you want to become a professor, or you want to work in industry. This could take up to 4 years to complete or more. It is funded by a supervisor, and there are collaborative programs available as well. The collaborative programs, they exist in water, nanotechnology, quantum information, and aeronautics. The interesting thing about the collaborative program is that you are not only working with students from engineering, but you could be working from students from all six faculties, depending on the program you choose. Water, a very important note, tuition fees are assessed based on your domestic residency status or international immigrant status. What this means is if you live in Ontario, there's a domestic Ontario tuition. You are a Canadian citizen or PR but live outside of the province of Ontario, there is another tuition fee. And then if you're international, there's another fee also. So there are 3 tuition rates applied to the students at the University of Waterloo. Financial support. That's the reason I believe most of you are on this call, so we'll just get to the meat of this webinar. So there's minimum funding, which is guaranteed, and this is only for students who are in the Master's of Applied Science and to the PhD program. It does not apply to students who are in the MEng or any of the course-based programs. Minimum funding is usually paid out in a GRS, Graduate Research Studentship. This information is applicable as of August 2023, so depending on when you're seeing this webinar, the rates could change. So for an MAC student, you receive $18,000 per year. Per year means for 3 terms. So you would get $18,000 for 1 year, and then you would get $18,000 in your second year. The PhD, that means you've completed PhD 2, you completed a master's. It's 12 terms, 4 years. You get $26,000 per year for 4 years. PhD 3, you're coming from a bachelor's. So this is 15 terms. You get 1 year more than PhD 2. It's $26,000 a year for 5 years. And this money is tax-free because it's a graduate research studentship. It's for students to do their research. And like I've said before, MEng, MMSC, MBET, MArch, there is no guaranteed funding. These are self-funded programs. Teaching assistantship, TA, and research assistantship, RA. And these are applicable to all programs. So we'll talk about TAs first. The hourly rate is what you should really notice. It's $45.90. These rates assume that you get 10 hours per week for 16 weeks during a term. And what I mean by that is you wouldn't normally get 160 hours over the term. So you would get the $45.90 per hour, but you wouldn't get the full 160 hours over the term. So just so you know that you're getting the $45.90, and then from there, that's how much that determines what your per term rate is. Graduate research assistantship, RA. So there are two rates. One is the master's rate and one is the doctoral rate. So the per hour rate is $43.77 for a master's student and $52.08 for a doctoral student. Once again, these rates are based on a 10 hour per week for 16 weeks for the term. And graduate students are not expected to work more than 10 hours per week during the term. You can hold a TA and an RA at the same time during a term, but typically you're not allowed to hold more than that. You're not allowed to work more than 20 hours a week in a term, because the expectation is that students are expected to focus on their studies and on their own research and not to do all this extra work on the side. Waterloo awards and scholarships. There are scholarships that are available, Masters of Applied Science students and PhD students. There are very few awards that are available to the course-based students. There is a database that is available to all students on campus. It's not just the Faculty of Engineering. What you need to do is you would go onto the website and you put in a key search word. And I would encourage all students, check this website out. I have to admit it's not the most user-friendly, but please look it up, because you might have a criteria that is not engineering focused, but you might be, say, in a unique category that enables you to hold an award that doesn't pertain to your studies, but it could be to your circumstance. So depending on your situation, you could be eligible for an award that has nothing to do with your studies as a student in engineering. So please look at this database and see if you're eligible for any of these awards. The Faculty of Engineering has awards that are specific just to students in the Faculty of Engineering. The first one is the Engineering Dean's Entrance Award. It's valued at $5,000. This is available to Canadian citizens or permanent residents, for students in the Masters of Applied Science and PhD programs. And these are for students who have received a minimum average of 85% or above at the time of application. We also have an Indigenous and Black Engineering and Technology Momentum Fellowships, IBET. These are valued at $30,000. And once again, for Canadian or permanent residents of Canada who identify as Indigenous or Black, applicants must be in a PhD program and they have to be full-time students to apply. There's also the Iron Ring Graduate Scholarship, valued up to $5,000. These are specific to students who are either University of Waterloo, the Faculty of Engineering, or Conestoga College graduate undergraduate programs. They are a graduate of these programs. It would be awarded to the student based on their academic excellence and leadership. And the value of the award is determined by my office. The Carl Pollock Postgraduate Fellowship in Engineering. This is open to any graduate of the University of Waterloo Faculty of Engineering undergraduate program. And this is for someone who's pursuing doctoral studies. This is a Provost Doctoral Entrance Award for women, valued at $5,000. This is available to women pursuing a doctoral program. You must have a minimum class standing of 80%, and you must have an outstanding record of research accomplishments and references citing your potential as a research student. And there's also external and government awards. These are mainly available only to Canadian and permanent residents, and they are generally only available to Masters of Applied Science students and PhD students. So there's the Canada Graduate Scholarship in the master's level, CGSM, valued at $17,500. It's available for 1 year and it's not renewable. The Canada Graduate Scholarship Doctoral Program, so the CGSD, it's valued at $35,000 for 3 years. And once again, this is not renewable. And then there's the NSERC Postgraduate Scholarship. It's at the doctoral level. It's PGSD, $21,000. You can get it either for 2 years or 3 years. Once again, that's not renewable. The Vanier Canada Graduate Scholarship, valued at $50,000 for 3 years, not renewable again. Ontario Graduate Scholarship and the Queen Elizabeth II Graduate Scholarship in Science and Technology, QE2 GSST, we refer to, is $15,000 for 1 year. This you can apply to more than once, and international students are eligible to apply for this, but we have very few quota for this. The recipients of any of the tri-agency awards that I listed and the OGS QE2 are also eligible to receive the Waterloo President's Graduate Scholarship, PGS, for the top-up valued at $10,000, and you would get that for the duration of how long you hold the tri-agency or the OGS. So if you were to hold, say, the Vanier, which is 3 years, you would get $10,000 for every year that you hold the Vanier. When students receive any of these major awards, this supersedes the minimum funding that you were guaranteed in your offer letter. I gave you a scenario here using the NSERC CGSM. So you get $17,500 plus the PGS of $10,000. So you would get $27,500. Which is more than the $18,000 guaranteed for an MASC student. So if you were guaranteed $26,000 in your offer letter, if you were to get a Vanier, which is $50,000, that means you get $50,000 as your minimum funding, and that $26,000 no longer applies. We also have, there's also some external awards. This award is actually all students are eligible to apply. So actually all master's students are eligible to apply to, even the MEng students. It's a merit-based entrance award, which recognizes exceptional candidates pursuing a master's or who are following an individualized study path that is demonstrated by AI. So it's valued at $17,500 for 1 year. The majority of the students who receive this award from Vector are in the MEng program. So I encourage students to look at this. If you're applying to our program, you should be looking at this award. International students. So the International Doctoral Student Award, IDSA, is valued at $15,420 per year for 4 years. These are current 2023 rates, and so typically it goes up every year. This is provided to all international students who are registered full-time, and the value is approximate to the difference in tuition between the domestic students and the international students. Please review the details carefully. There are some variations if you are coming with sponsorship from your home country. International Master's Award of Excellence, IMA. This is valued at $2,500 per term for 5-term maximum. So this means if the total value of the award is $12,500. The faculty will nominate eligible students based on the quota that we receive every year. This quota changes. So not all Master's of Applied Studies students will receive this. It's only students that are eligible, and depending on the quota, only certain students will get it. And when I refer to the IDSA, there are international agreements and sponsorships that come from all over the world, and we really encourage students to check these out. Depending where you're coming, there could be a sponsorship or an international agreement that your country has that might benefit you when you apply to one of our programs here in Canada. Budget. GSPA has a nice little student budget calculator. So when you do that, it automatically shows up what the tuition fee would be, what the cost of books would be, and if you want to live off campus. And it just provides you with a nice scenario, what you should expect your budget to be for the year. There's also a link that tells you what to expect for food, for telephone, entertainment, personal care, and other things. This is just a very modest budget. Some students maybe spend more on food, might not do much entertainment. So this is just a very modest, we're not saying this is going to be what students spend, but it's something to take into account when you're trying to calculate your budget. There also is a YouTube video about talking about graduate housing questions that students have, which we know most graduate students have about when they want to move to Waterloo.
Thank you very much, Rita, for all this explanation. Of course, there's a lot of information that you need to understand as a student. So please, again, just go to our website. You will find all the information that we just explained. You can visit our graduate studies page and the guide with even more information about it. Also, you can request more information so you can be in our database and receive all the updated information that we want to share with you. And you can sign up for upcoming information sessions. We host webinars like this one explaining relevant information that applies for all the departments, and we also host different webinars by department, so you have a clear path when you want to study here in the Faculty of Engineering at the University of Waterloo.